Good morning everyone, I'm Dr. Kirti. Today we'll be discussing about neutropenic diet and neutropenic care. So basically, what is neutropenic? So neutropenic is nothing but usually in hematological conditions, neutropenic care and diet becomes very important. So why it is important, I will let you know. In hematology, malignancies and disorders, basically there are three things, that is white blood cell, red blood cells and platelets involved. So white blood cells are the one that fight against infections usually. So white blood cells, when they are low because of the treatment or the condition itself, when they are low, what happens is we are prone for many infections. So to fight against it, we don't have any cells, WBC cells left. That is why we have to properly take care of ourselves or the patients with neutropenic care or diet. Okay, that is why it becomes important. And platelets, what happens when the platelets are low? They tend to bleed. So to try to prevent that, even in care we have some points. Okay, so first thing, when you come to neutropenic care, there are three things that we have to be bothered and worried about. One is personal hygiene, other one is oral hygiene and perianal care. So we'll discuss about these three things today. Bathing, daily bathing is compulsory and no excuse in that, and there is no laziness to be done. Okay, daily bath with normal or warm water is preferable. Coming to oral hygiene, oral hygiene have to be done in two ways. One is by mouthwash or mouth gargle, where usually chlorhexidine gargle has to be used. So usually we have to use it at least 6 times a day, that is before food and after food. So morning, afternoon, evening, 3 times a day. So this helps you by cleaning any particles of food left stuck in the teeth, in between the teeth. This is with the oral hygiene, mouth gargling. Next thing is soft brush. So the brushing of teeth has to be used to be done twice daily. One is morning and other one is during the bedtime. You have to use a soft brush, because if you use a hard brush, what happens is there is a high chances of gum bleeding. So soft brush is soft and it does not hurt your gums and cause bleeding. That is why you have to use the soft brush. And perianal care. Perianal care is something very important. When a patient is passing a motion or stools, they have to wash the area with soap and water and dry the area cleanly with a towel or tissues. Never keep the area wet, because it can cause chances of infection over there. Never do heavy workouts. There is a minimal requirement of walking and all these things, but never do heavy workouts, because when patients do heavy workouts, they tend to sweat a lot and they get tired, they get weakness, which is harmful for the patient. And if at all you have done some workouts and you are sweating, always consider taking bath after this. Next thing, there are many questions about what kind of place you need to stay and how to clean the area where you are staying, how to travel to the hospital and everything. Now we will be considering those questions also. First thing, when you are in this care, you should avoid crowded places, because the more crowded it is, the more exposure you are for any infection, viruses, etc. That is the reason why you have to avoid crowded places like malls, shopping, etc. Okay, then how to choose a home. Usually we ask our patients to stay in a nearby area, because when the patient gets sick, you need to reach to the hospital within half an hour to 1 hour after patient is sick. That is any fever, cold or any of these above things. Patient needs to reach to hospital within half an hour to 1 hour. That is the reason why we always tell our patients to choose a home which is nearby, near to the hospital. So how to choose a home? The area has to be clean. Not too much of dust or traffic has to be there. Next thing, there should be no ongoing construction nearby the home. Okay, when there is more construction areas or any construction areas near home, please don't choose that area, because what will happen is there is always a chances of fungal infections and spores entering into the body and causes fungal infection to the patient, which is very difficult to treat in patients. Okay, try to choose a place without any open sewage or drainages nearby, which is preferably. Okay, then how to clean the room or the house. So the room has to be cleaned with wet mopping morning and evening. Always never try to dust, because whenever you're dusting with the mop, what happens is there is a dust which is going up, which can again cause fungal infection. So always try doing it wet mopping, and you can use a vacuum cleaner, but preferable is always a wet mopping. Then how to travel to the hospital? So since we always prefer our patients to stay nearby, it is okay to come by walk if you're staying nearby to the hospital, and it is a walkable distance. It is okay to come by walk, but you have to use the personal protection like mask, goggles, or a eye shield to be used. Never use a public transport like buses or an auto. It is always preferable to use a car or a cab. But we'll talk about what kind of masks are available and what can you use. Actually, recent times, there are many kinds of masks available online and in the stores, in the market. That is why it is always important to choose the right kind of mask, which is N95 mask. So there are many types of N95 masks. This is an N95 mask which is available, and you can use this without a valve, which is important. Okay, you can use this mask. It is to be a tight fitting mask. Okay, it has to be not loose and where the exposure can happen. You shouldn't use that kind. And these are the masks that many people use. And don't use this mask this mask alone. It is not good to use. Okay, and there are other types of N95 masks. This is an N95 mask but with a valve. So what happens is there is a high chance of exposure, okay, with this mask. So what you have to do is you have to use this mask first. On top of that, you have to use this mask. Okay, always preferable to use this way. Next thing, to protect, you need a protective eyewear. Usually goggles can be used as a protective eyewear, but preferably, if not this, you can use an eye shield which covers the whole face. So it's preferable to use an eye shield. We are done with neutropenic care. We'll be learning now about neutropenic diet.